An Islamic State leader is killed in Syria by Turkey's intelligence forces. That's according to Turkish President Tayyip Erdogan. The leader was identified as Abu Hussein al-Qurashi, who took over the group in November 2022 after his predecessor was killed in southern Syria. The Islamic State took over large parts of Syria and Iraq in 2014, but it lost its grip on these areas after campaigns by U.S.-backed forces, as well as Syrian forces backed by Iran, Russia, and various paramilitaries. A massive manhunt is underway in Houston, Texas, following a mass shooting. Over 200 law enforcement officers there are tracking down a man accused of shooting dead his five neighbors, his youngest victim, an eight-year-old. Francisco Oropesa allegedly opened fire on his neighbors Friday night after they asked him to stop shooting a rifle in his yard. Local police admit they have zero leads on his whereabouts. Officials are offering an $80,000 reward for information that will lead to the suspect's arrest.
Right now, we just don't know, because if we did, we would have him in custody right now. We don't have any tips right now to where he may be. And that's why we've come up with this reward, so that hopefully somebody out there can call us. I pretty much can guarantee you he's contacted some of his friends. We just don't know what friends they are. And that's what we need from the public, is any type of information, because right now we're running into dead ends.
A gas leak in the northern state of Punjab has left at least 9 people dead. The cause of the leak is still under investigation. Industrial gas leaks blamed on poor safety standards and insufficient checks are common in India. In August last year, over 100 women were hospitalized after a similar incident at an apparel manufacturing plant in the southern state of Andhra Pradesh. 2 months before that, in June, around 200 women fell unconscious after a gas leak in the same area. Preparations for the coronation of King Charles III in full swing. Troops from the UK and around the Commonwealth already held full rehearsal of the military procession for the coronation on May 6th. Meanwhile, an elaborate anointing screen will be used during the coronation, featuring a tree that represents the Commonwealth.
Well, the inspiration of the screen is actually the stained glass window behind the screen St. James's Chapel, which was done in the Golden Jubilee, for the Golden Jubilee in 2002. What's at the heart of it is all about collaboration. It's about the Commonwealth, how the countries work together, and how the King is, in fact, at the centre of that, and bringing together everybody, diverse countries, bringing them together to work together. And that's exactly how we've run this project.
Buckingham Palace earlier released photographs of King Charles and his wife, Camilla, the Queen Consort, ahead of their coronation. The historic Stone of Scone arrives in London's Westminster Abbey. The stone was moved from its permanent home at Edinburgh Castle for the first time in more than 25 years to be used for the coronation of King Charles III. That chair has been used in the coronation ceremonies of English and British monarchs since 1399.
Well, of course, the stone being back here is a sense of real unity. There's a big history behind this, which started with a bit of enmity, and then the late Queen brought it back in a kindness to Scotland in 1996, and it comes down as a unity symbol of friendship and part of Scotland's contribution to the coronation.